And I wish I could have said all that by memory, but maybe I've been eating the wrong foods. Because we are learning that eating ultra-processed foods like instant noodles, white bread, frozen dinners like the TV dinners and sugary drinks may be linked to a faster rate of cognitive decline, contributing to perhaps Alzheimer's disease. That was one of the studies presented yesterday at the Alzheimer's Association International Conference in San Diego, California. Sarah Lovegreen is with the Missouri chapter of the Alzheimer's Association, and she joins us right now via Zoom. Were you supposed to go to that conference?
Not this year.
Oh, good. Yeah, it's better to stay home anyhow. We got so much going on. Everybody's spreading things around these days. Probably best to stay home. All right, let's talk about this. The London study found that those who ate the most ultra-processed foods had a 28% faster decline in cognitive scores. Explain that.
Yeah, so we're continuing to build this body of evidence to really understand how these preventive health behaviors like healthy eating, exercise, et cetera, really impact our cognitive health and brain health. And this is just one another building block to say that really, as much as we can eat those fruits and vegetables, those lean meats, low fat foods, keeping really with a heart healthy diet, that's going to benefit our brain the most. And as we eat more of those ultra-processed foods, we're putting ourselves at greater risk.
Yeah, you got to exercise too. Don't smoke, that's bad. Moderation with alcohol. I know that the study did mention a glass of wine a night is okay.
Yeah, so it's really that full spectrum. I know a lot of people are looking for that magic bullet to avoid Alzheimer's disease and other chronic conditions. And what we're learning is really the best way to avoid it is, finding this balance of healthy eating, great movement, staying socially engaged, and avoiding smoking and alcohol, those things that we know are detrimental.
Yeah, it goes on to mention some of the foods, more leafy greens, blueberries, whole grains, oats, brown rice. Unsalted almonds, walnuts, hazelnuts, beans, fish for the omega-3 and all of that. It's stuff we've heard many, many times before. But oftentimes, genetically, if you're going to get Alzheimer's, they don't know what causes it, but maybe you'd get it despite the diet. I don't know.
For some, that may be true. I think we want to give people as many tools as possible to reduce their risk and understand, sort of what may be putting them at risk. And that's where some of this research is coming forward. We do know that there's a very small group of the population that are genetically designated to get Alzheimer's disease, but that's such a small group that for the vast majority of us, it really is sort of these, what are the lifestyle factors, maybe some genetic predisposition, but not necessarily something that's telling us we're going to have the disease.
All right. Sarah Lovegreen is with the Missouri chapter of the Alzheimer's Association. This conference is going on all week in San Diego, so keep us posted. There could be all kinds of interesting things coming out of that. We appreciate your time.
Thank you.
You're welcome.